Hi friends, welcome to Learner.Guru. Nowadays, current affairs play a crucial role for students when they want to prepare for competitive exams. Not only for competitive exams, even the exams conducted for jobs and interviews also contain questions on general awareness. So in our video, we see the current affairs on 14 October 2018. Now we see the first question, the biography of late Anumolu Ramakrishnan titled Building a Legacy is authored by whom? The answer is V. Pattabhiram. The biography of late Anumolu Ramakrishnan titled Building a Legacy is authored by city-based chartered account V. Pattabhiram. It was recently released by Vice President M. Venkaya Naidu. Ramakrishna, former president and MD at Larsen and Toubro, was posthumously awarded Padma Bhushan in 2014. He was instrumental in constructing several path-breaking buildings, including Tirumala Q Complex, High Tech City and Nehru Indoor Stadium. Ramakrishna was born in December 1939 and died on August 20, 2030 at Hyderabad. Now we see the next question. Which IIT has signed pact with Norwegian University of Science and Technology, NTNU, in research and education? The answer is IIT Kharagpur. The IIT Kharagpur and Norwegian University of Science and Technology have signed an MOU to facilitate cooperation in research and education between the two institutes in New Delhi on October 11. NTNU is an expert in hydropower, ocean modeling, deep sea resources and marine technology, which will be key areas of focus under this MOU. IIT KGP has three departments and centers. Working in these areas, the Department of Ocean Engineering and Naval Architecture, the Center for Oceans, Rivers, Atmosphere and Land Science, and the Department of Civil Engineering with its core areas in hydronomics, coastal marine and hydraulic engineering and wave modeling. Both IIT, KGP and NTNU have transdisciplinary academic and research programs encompassing science and technology, medicine, social science to arts and fine arts, and more areas of common interest will be explored in future. Now we see the next question. Which Indian state has won the FAO's Future Policy Gold Award for 100% organic farming? The answer is Sikkim. Sikkim has won the Gold at 2018 FAO's Future Policy Award for its achievement in becoming the world's first total organic agricultural state. All of its farmland is certified organic. At the same time, Sikkim's approach reaches beyond organic production and has proven truly transformational for the state and its citizens. Uniquely, the state has totally banned the sale and use of chemical pesticides. The transition has benefited more than 66,000 farming families. The Sikkim tourism sector has benefited greatly from the state's transition to 100% organic. The number of tourists increased by over 50% between 2014 and 2017. Sikkim beat out 51 other nominees from around the world for the award. Brazil, Denmark, Cuba, and Ecuador share the silver award, nicknamed the Oscar for Best Policies. The award is co-organized with the FAO by the World Future Council and IFOAM. Organics International and recognizes the world's best laws and policies promoting agroecology. Now we see the next question. The World Bank has ranked India at which position in its first ever Human Capital Index? The answer is 115th. The World Bank has recently released its first ever Human Capital Index, which ranked 157 economics and parameters like child mortality, health and education. India is ranked at 150th position in the index with a score of 0.44 on a scale of 0 to 1, coming even below the average score for South Asia. Though Government of India has rejected the findings of the index, India's neighbors Bangladesh, Nepal and Sri Lanka were better placed at 106 and honored second and 74th position respectively. Singapore topped the poll after it was highly rated for its universal healthcare system, education exams, results and life expectancy figures. It is followed by South Korea, Japan, Hong Kong and Finland. Now we see the next question. The National Stock Exchange has recently signed pact with which state government to fuel MSMEs growth in the state? The answer is Uttarakhand. The National Stock Exchange has recently signed pact with the Uttarakhand government to provide access to capital MSMEs, which will fuel growth of such entities in the state. The boards will play an active role in nurturing the SMEs and startups by increasing awareness along with the government and the opportunities to raise capital, SME exchange guidelines, listing process, compliances with listing agreement, among others. As part of the pact, the exchange will support the efforts of the government in enhancing the financing opportunities for micro, small and medium enterprises in the state through listening on NSE's SME platform merge. On its part, the government will facilitate MSMEs to get listed on the NSE emerge by supporting such entities financially or otherwise in bearing the expenses related to listing. Thank you. In our next video, we see the upcoming current affairs. If you like this video, subscribe our channel www.learner.guru.